Excellent. So, see, what we are going to look at today is the most important aspect of chess, okay? All the way till you become a master, okay? And what is that? It is tactics, okay? Tactics are short sequence of moves, maybe one move, maybe two moves, maybe three, maybe four moves, but mostly within two, three, four moves, within which one side gets a tremendous advantage. Okay, maybe one side at our level, tremendous advantage at your level might mean that you win a rook or you win a queen or you give a checkmate. And as you go higher at a master level, it might even win winning a pawn also for free. Okay. But that is at a slightly higher level. But that is also called as a tactical, because at a master level, if you are one pawn down, then almost 90% of the time you will lose the game. Okay, because they will not make silly mistakes and they will convert it. So, but at your level, it is okay, good enough to convert a minor piece up. So, if you are 3 points up, you should be able to win it without any mistakes. That should be your aim. Okay. And what happens is, most of the times, most games are decided by tactics. Okay. Last week, I had sent some links about how to analyze the games on Lee Chess. Has anyone done that? I think Agastya, you had sent, sorry, Akash, you had sent me an invite for a study. I didn't get time, but did you do that? Have you, has anyone analyzed their game on Lee Chess? Okay, someone is, Vihan has raised the hand. I will, Vihan, you go ahead and speak and tell.
Yes, sir. I wanted to say I have created a tactic study and I didn't analyze my game. I will do it next time.
Yeah, okay, fine. I think Agastya and Mishti have also raised their hands, but I will go next time. I will give the thing, okay? Or okay, let me give Agastya. What is it?
I have for after most of my after most after some of my matches. When I just got to know how we can analyze, I analyze my games.
Okay, very good. So maybe we'll just show how it looks like. Okay, so when you say Agastya, what is your ID? MC1 underscore Agastya or what?
MC1 underscore Agastya.
Okay, let me go here. MC1 underscore Agastya. Yeah, Agastya. Okay, and you have got, okay, let me see, 494 games you have studied, and here last game was against Mishti. Okay, and before that, let me see which game have you analyzed. I don't see
Game about Sir, I've analyzed in arenas.
yeah, arenas also. It will actually come here. If you are okay, if you have done the computer analysis, it will come here. Okay, so no problem. I think it is okay. I will just you can just see the links that I had sent, but it allows you to do Mishti. Okay, Mishti, go ahead. I have allowed
Sir,
you.
after my tournaments, while tournament, while I'm playing, my father joins and watches, or after the tournaments, we check the matches.
Have you checked the computer analysis?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you have checked it, then you will come to know. But anyway, let me go ahead and tell. Okay, so let me so I will mute you back. Okay, fine. So let's go back. Okay, see, tactics are, I think all of you will get the idea what is a tactic. Okay, so maybe I will just increase this. Okay, can you see this left side board here, or is it too small? I think it may be too small. Okay, it may be too small, but there is a check, so there is a double check. So that in the can you see this first thing under checks? Can you see it? Not yet, huh? It's too small. Yeah, it is too small. Don't worry, I will give a big one. Okay, don't worry. Checks, captures, both at once. Okay, yeah. Okay, all right. I will show you. Let me show you on Lee Chess puzzles itself. See, Lee Chess has got this under a lot of puzzles are there, and you can do this and. Let us do hanging piece and let us do normal, not even normal. Let us do okay. Let us see this. Who is to play? I think it is white to play. White to play, obviously it is very simple, right? What would white play here? What would white play here? Can you okay, queen to h8. Yeah, queen to h8 is one option, right? What is another option? Is there another option? Yeah, bishop to c6, right? Bishop to c6. I would play bishop to c6. Why? Because this knight is pinned. And queen can capture it, but first I will capture this. Okay, because it's a check. I don't know why it is saying. Okay, it is saying queen to a check. Yeah, but you got the idea, right? I mean, you got the idea. So let us go to even thing. So this is a case of a hanging piece. I will show you on Chess King also. I will show you. Okay, so fine. So let us go back to the thing. So that is a hanging piece, and let me go to back to the chess themes. Yeah, themes. Let us go back. See, there is also a. There are so many different tactics. Okay, we will show you one more here. I'll show you one by one. Check and double attack. Right, check and double attack. Let us see a check and a double attack. Discovered attack. Yeah. This is the position white to play. White to play discovered attack. Okay. Maybe I should give us easiest example first. Yeah. Let us give an easiest example first. Yeah. Can you play in this black to play here? Can you suggest a move for, and you will come to know what is I mean by a tactic. Black to play. Knight to g3. Who said that? Yashika. Right. Knight to g3. It is a discovered attack, because now with the knight, you are giving a check to the king. King has to move. Meanwhile, queen will go and capture the white queen. You got it? So this was a tactic. Right? This was a tactic. Correct. Knight to g3. Right? Okay, let me see. Some people have entered the this one. Admit all. Yeah. So this was the tactic, right? Similarly, let me go to another theme. We can go, or we can continue on the same this one. But there are so many types of tactics exist. Okay. So if you go to, let us go to a fork. Okay, and I will go to easiest. Okay, yeah, this is black to play. Black to play. Bishop crosses e. Not e4. What is that? I think. Yeah, rook takes e4. Rook takes e4. What is the thing? It is checking the king also and simultaneously attacking this knight also. Right? So you managed to eat two of them. Right? So this became a tactic. Right? Yeah, you're right. I think everybody got it. Rook to e4 gives a check and then gives a thing. This was a fork. Fork by a rook, because fork means two things you are attacking at the same time. Right, then let us look at a double check, and let us look at it easiest here. It is who is to play? It is, let me see, who is to play? Black has played, so it is white to play. Yeah, white to play here. Yeah, Vihan has given me, and Ramnath has also given me knight to h6. Okay, double checking. After this, what is the next move? It is not kh6, it is nh6. And please remember, n should be capital. K is not correct. Okay, but can you see? Yeah, you gave a check, but actually, white is winning instantly after this. White is winning instantly. Can you see how? Can you see? It is a smothered mate that is coming. Queen will go to g8, check the king. No option, because the knight is supporting the king. So queen. So king cannot capture it. Only rook can capture it. And now what is it? Yeah, knight to f7. It is smothered mate. Right? No. Rook to g7 would not work. Knight to f7. Knight to f7 is checkmate. Right? Okay. So you got the idea. So these are the types of tactics. Let me go back. Okay. So this was just to show you that there are so many types of tactics. Okay. And it is very, very important for you to understand the types of tactics and start making. So there are over maybe 30 different types of tactics. Okay. But right now in level 2, I will want you to learn about 6 tactics only. So even the next, there will be one more lecture also on this. But we are even looking at a more thing. Why and when do tactics occur? Okay. So why and when do tactics occur? So that is what we'll first look at. And then you have to train your brain to start looking for those tactics. Okay. So typically tactics occur when there is an unsafe king. Okay, this is one of the characteristics. If the king is not very safe, then many times some tactic will occur. Okay, now can you see this position on the right side here? Can you see this position on the right side here? Top position, right? In this position, see it is looking. White queen is on h4, black queen is on c3. Okay, and the king is, though he's castled, is the rook is not on the last line. Rook is away somewhere. Okay, so the last rank is very weak, and this results in a tactic. And what does white play? White plays queen to e7 here. Queen goes from h4 to e7. Okay, and then after that, black has got no easy way, because white is threatening the rook also and threatening checkmate also, and there is no or. If queen goes to f6, then white queen will simply go to e8, and then it's a checkmate. If the rook goes down, then he will get killed. If the rook goes to e6, right? Rook goes to e6, queen is on e7, then queen will go to d8 and give a check. Okay? And then the rook will have to come down and get sacrificed, and again it will be checkmate. Right? So no matter what black does now, it is going to be, after queen e7, there is no easy way. It is completely lost position. Means black is going to lose a rook at least. Okay. Black is going to lose a rook at least. Because if he wants to save the mate, he might push the pawn in front of the king. And then this will be gone. Okay. Okay. So many people have raised the hands. No. I think who has a question? Ramnath has a question. So please raise this one. Ramnath, please raise the hand if you have a question. Okay. So fine. So you got this idea here. What happens? Okay. Similarly, there is another time when the tactics occur is if your pieces are not well defended. Okay. And sometimes, rarely this may happen, but it may happen in a master game also. So this is an example. Okay, this is a game where ex-world champion Anatoly Karpov actually lost this game in maybe 10 or 12 moves, because he was playing this, and he in this opening here, and he played knight to h5 as black. See this position here, loose pieces under here. And now, can you see it's a double attack after this? What is the double attack? White gets to move to queen to d1, and then he is attacking the knight also, as well as attacking bishop on d6. Right? When he does that, there is absolutely no way for black to defend both of them. One of them they can defend. Yeah, queen to d1. Right? Queen to d1, and then one of them they will have to defend, and the other will go away. Right? I mean, other will get captured for free. And it is like, this is a master game, grandmaster game, top grandmaster game. If you win a knight, then there is no absolutely no chance. So Karpov resigned here after White played queen to d1, right? So why did this happen? Is that see, the bishop on d6, normally there is the d7 pawn would have first moved up and then only the bishop will come there. So queen would be supporting the bishop. But this is a peculiar case where the pawn has not moved and the bishop has come in front of the pawn. So there is no support. So this is a loose piece. And then when knight goes to h5, it is also not defended. So it is a loose piece. There is no defense. And now when in such a condition, it is suitable for tactics. Okay, so tactics may occur. So always look for if the king is weak, look for it. If there is some weakness as in undefended pieces are lying around of your opponent, then you have to look whether you can attack thing. Okay, Mishti, I have allowed you to unmute.
Sir, I have beaten one person in 4 moves.
Okay, what did you give that? Fool's mate or scholar's mate?
I don't know.
Okay. Checkmate on f2, f7, I think, right? Queen f7 checkmate?
Yes. Queen supporting by the bishop.
Bishop, that is the scholar's mate. Yeah, correct. Great. So that is also a tactic, right? Mate is also a tactic. Right? So cool. So this is what I mean, okay? And now it is to, right now it is to introduce you just to some tactics, okay? So it is important, and there is a lot of tactics examples are available for solving on Lee Chess also and Chess King also, okay? So now what we are going to do is we are going to look at an ABCs of tactics, okay? Very basics, okay? Understand? And what are the types of tactics? So obviously first one here, obviously everyone knows white to play. Forks, right? I mean, it is not even fork, loose piece. That is the first one. Second number, outnumbered pieces. Second position here, where the knight is circled, right? It is shown as outnumbered pieces. Yeah, first one is queen to f5, correct? Second one, next to it. See, the knight is defended only twice, but attacked 3 times. So you can simply kill it. You can kill it. In fact, it is whether you should kill it with the queen or with this one. Yeah, there are a lot of options. I think you can kill it with the bishop also. Yeah, bishop to d5. Not queen into knight. No, not queen into knight, because rook will capture the queen. Then it will be a draw. Most, not draw, but equal chances. So you have to capture it with the rook or with the bishop. Yeah. What is the third one? It is a fork. I think it is already given. See, the knight fork, that is called as a fork. Okay. Third position, the knight is there, black to play, knight is there, where it is, if it lands on that square marked with a cross, then it will be giving a check to the king as well as attacking the queen, right? So when the same piece attacks two things simultaneously, it is called as a fork, okay? So the knight landing on e3, knight to e3 check, king will move and then queen will get captured, right? It is a fork. What is the next one? Next one is called as a net. Why it is net means it is a trapped piece. Okay. It is as good as you have captured somebody under the net, like those hunters, not hunters. You remember those, some of those things, they capture the birds or some other animals by putting the net. So yeah. So now what happens is when the knight is, it is trapped knight, it has no way to come out. It will get captured. Yeah. So bishop to d8 will capture it. Yeah. Fine. What is the next one? Is pin. Next one is a pin. I think we had learnt it already last week. So you will know the thing. Black to play. What is the move? It is already marked there. Yeah, bishop to c6. Pinning the queen against the king and then winning it. Right? So after maybe black king will also move to f3, and when you kill the queen, he will kill the bishop. But what is the position after that? You have 2 pawns, one on king side, one on queen side. So you will be able to promote one of the pawn to become a queen, right? So that is what will happen. Okay. Now there is one more variant of pin. Actually, it is not pin. It is called as a skewer. And can you see the next position? It is called as a skewer. And why it is called as a skewer, you will come to know. What is the move there? Yeah, again, the move is bishop to c6. but it is the bishop to c6 check. Okay, and the king will necessarily have to move the what is written as a skewer, that position, Ramnath, the position under skewer next to pin. Yeah, so king will have to move, and there is a piece behind the king which you can capture it. Yeah. It is so. It is not attacking the rook indirectly. It is first attacking the king, and king will move, and then you will win the rook. Right? It is the reverse of the skewer. Skewer may you attack something which cannot move. Skewer may you attack something which necessarily has to move, and then you will kill the thing behind it. Okay. So this is a thing. So there are some more examples. So let us. Oops, sorry. Yeah, there is some more examples here. There are some more examples. What is the? This is a. See what happens is. Look under the position ties undermining. Okay, ties undermining. Here what happens is. Both queens are facing each other, both rooks are facing each other, but depending on which side is to play, that side will win. Yeah, if you are right, Yashika, if white to play, then what will white do? First he will kill the queen, exchange the queen, king will have to take the queen, and then your rook will kill the other party's rook, because that was defended by the queen. Once queens are gone, then that rook is defenseless. So white to play, queen takes d8, king takes d8, and then rook takes the other rook on a5, right? So that is a thing that is called as undermining, because something which was defending it, undermining, you know, it is comes from the military again word, and mining and undermining, yeah, like you put mines under it, right? Yeah, rook and king can checkmate after that. There is something also called as overloading. Okay, overloading, ties means overloading also. So what happens is, here look at the position under ties overloading. Okay, what is the thing? Queen is white. Queen is facing the rook on c7. The rook is defended by the queen on d8, but there is a back rank which is weak. Yeah. So if white queen takes the rook under the overloading section, then queen will have to take the rook, and then white rook will go to e8 and give a checkmate. Yeah. Yeah, exactly, right? Okay, there is one more type of tactic called as jumps. Jumps is nothing but discovery, okay? Unmasking or discovery. The next position under it. Look at it, and then you will come to know why it is a jump. Knight to f4, correct? Ramnath, not k to f4, n to f4. Okay, knight to f4. It's a discovered check. Why it is a discovered check? Because knight is not giving the check. You are moving the knight, but knight is not moving the check. But queen is checking, the black queen is ending up checking the white king. Meanwhile, the knight attacks the white queen. And what can you do when the king is under check? You cannot save the queen. You have to first save the king. And when you save the king, that time, next move, black will capture the queen, right? So this is a very powerful tactic. Okay, discovered attack is called as, and we call it as also a jump. Okay, discovered attack. Vihan, okay, let me, yeah, Vihan.
So in the first one, ties undermining, I have a better tactic.
Okay, what is it?
The rook can go to h8, give a check, and we'll get a queen and a rook for free.
Yeah, that is also a good idea. Very good idea. No, absolutely right. You are right. Rook can go to h8 also. You are right. And the king will have to come up, and then you can win the...
We'll have better points then.
Yes. That is correct. Good, fine. Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. Then there is a checkmate is also a tactic. Okay. Checkmates also... See, there are some obvious checkmates, but there are not some obvious checkmates. Okay. Not obvious checkmates. And you have to... See, can you see here in the under checkmate, what is the position? It is who is to play? It is
white to play. Of course, sir. It's a checkmate.
It is already a checkmate. Black has given a checkmate, right? Because yeah. The white queen is already preventing the king from going to c2. and it is under check. No, and what are the rules? You cannot avoid the check, you cannot block the check, and you cannot capture the checking piece. If A, B, C, both of them are not there, all three of them are not there, then it's a checkmate, right? So it's already a checkmate. There is one more type of interesting type of tactic. We are just introducing, okay? And that's why I'm just giving you one, but there are hundreds and hundreds of examples are there and for you to practice also, I will show you that. Now, this is called as a decoy. So can you see the position under decoy? No, it is okay. If you play queen to g6, now it doesn't help. It doesn't help actually. No. We'll see this move. Why don't we see this move on the board? And you will come to know. Pawn is on b2, queen is on f1, g8, e1, and e4. Okay, let me put this position on the board. Hold it. Clear board. Black pawn is on b. King is on e8. Queen is here. White queen is on f8. And white king is on e4. And it is black to play. Okay? It is black to play. Just to make it orientation right, I have turned it. Yeah. Black to play. Okay? What would be the best position for black? Not position, for move for black. Queen to g6 is not. Queen to g6 is not a great move. There is a better move. Yeah, pawn to bishop, sorry, pawn to b1 and becoming a queen, giving a check and attacking the white queen simultaneously. So what will white have to do now? What is white? White has no option other than capturing the queen, right? And then what comes? Then you get a skewer. Queen to g6 is a skewer. Queen to g6 is a skewer. King is under check. King has to move somewhere. And after that, you will kill the queen. And after that, you should be able to checkmate in 7-8 moves after this. Right? So yeah. Yeah, Mishti. Go ahead. I have allowed you to unmute.
Sir, can you go to the starting position once?
Yeah. Can go to the starting position. Yeah.
Sir, first black has to move forward, then there's a better move for white.
No. What is the best better move for black? You tell me.
After black moves, makes that queen.
Yeah.
Queen should go to D. There.
Okay. Yeah, even then black will take it. You will take it. What is the result? Result so then, is black is one queen up, right?
Yeah. Okay.
So it is the same thing. Right. Net, you are losing a queen. Ramnath, you have to... Okay, I have allowed you to unmute.
Sir, can you go to the starting position?
Yeah.
Sir, if the queen black will move to, then king will move, and then king will move to e3.
Yeah. Or e3, okay. Then you will push the pawn, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is also okay. But see, this is what you would normally do. But I wanted to show you a tactic with a skewer. That's why I said. Right. Yeah, it is this way also it is possible in this particular position, but remember sometimes it may not be possible. So that is here it is possible. Queen g6 will also win.
Chakar yes, mama. So I have an even better move. Can you get to the starting position, please, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, if we give a check and if the queen comes to f5, then we'll give a check from b.
All of those moves are, it is ultimately, it is the same thing. What happens is even then.
No, sir. I didn't want to do this. Please. Yeah. And after that, promote the pawn.
Yeah. It's
got the queen, check, and the queen is unprotected. Now you can kill the queen for free.
Yeah.
Two
but why would white put a thing like this? White will not put a queen to f5, right? When you give this check on queen to g6, white will not do this, right? White, why will white do this? White will just move the king to maybe e3, right? So it doesn't matter anyway. I think you got the idea what I was saying.
We can give more checks and just...
fine. So decoy, that was there, and there is one more called as a beautiful example here, called as a clearance, square clearance it is. Can you see this move here? Can you see this? I will put it otherwise on the board. Queen is on. Okay. Let me try to put it here.
Sir, I think meeting is going to end in 4 minutes.
Yeah. We are also done. So, okay.
All the best for the tournament then. So I also created a study tactic in this chess study.
Oh, okay. But see, the key thing is that I'm not asking you. Acha, you created a study. But studying, you should do it only. Yeah, but otherwise solve the problems actually. So that is what.
I did solve it.
Okay, all right. Yeah, this is the position, and it is white to play. Yeah, white to play. And white has got a beautiful tactic here, white to play.
So, pawn beats queen, beats this knight.
Excuse me, sir, we don't have to kill it with the queen. If the queen is off the area, then it will be a checkmate. So we can kill it with the pawn. The king will open up a bit and they can't do a checkmate.
No. This is not a good move. There is a better move that is available for her. Because with this move, what will happen is black will simply take this. The knight.
Okay. Right? We also had a knight.
Instead, queen will take the knight.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I put the position wrong somewhere.
Yeah, I also think.
Yeah, it is the black queen, right? And it is the white. Yeah. All position is all wrong. Position is all wrong. That's all. So let me analyze. What is this? Okay. Okay. It is. Black knight should be here, and black queen should be here, and white knight obviously will be here, and it is white queen, yeah, and it is black to play, yeah. Sorry about that. It is, yeah. This is the position, and it is black to play.
So the knight can give a check. At c1.
It is black to
rook,
play.
Sorry, the rook can give a check.
Rook.
I meant the rook.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so. I think there should be a pawn here. There should be a pawn, white pawn on c2. C2. Sorry about that. I think it is. I have not said.
No problem.
I think the key tactic what I wanted to show is queen takes knight. White will take this, but then after that, knight gets a fork here. Yeah. This is the thing. After that, king will have to move, and then the knight will capture the queen. I think I have not set up the position correctly. The rook could not have given the checkmate. Okay, that is the thing. But key.
So can you show it again?
Yeah. See what black does is, and white is called as a clearance. He is taking a clearing the square for the knight to come in. And white will have to take it, and then the knight gets a fork. Okay, let's do one thing. Let us join back. Okay, I'm going to stop the recording, and let us join back. And
sorry, in 2 minutes.